Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. In today's video, we're gonna be discussing swing set steering. I know this is a topic of confusion for a lot of people, and it definitely was for us as well when we first started getting into it. I know as soon as you see a bunch of tie rods and Heims, you just start getting really confused and you don't really understand what's happening. But in this two-part series, I'm gonna be trying to relay as much information to you guys as possible so you can proficiently know how this setup works and how to set it up on your own. Like with the other videos in this series, I'm gonna start this video with some announcements and disclaimers. And the first announcement I wanna make, which some of you probably already noticed, is that we moved to two videos a week again. We've been on one video a week for quite some time, but now we're finally back at two, which was one of my goals for this summer. I'm gonna try and keep doing two videos a week for as long as I possibly can. Right now it's good because we have a build that we can be filming and I can be filming this series, so there's plenty of content to go through. I do start school for some summer classes at the start of August, so I'm gonna try and get ahead on some videos. That way we can continue with two videos a week throughout that month. So that's something to look forward to. And the next thing I wanna say is thank you to everyone who went and bought merchandise after the last video. I mentioned it very briefly at the start and we got quite a few orders. So thank you to everyone who went and did that and supported us. By the time you're watching this video, we just released some stickers. Literally right when this video dropped, there's stickers out now. So if you guys wanna pick up some stickers and some shirts, head on over to the website and do so. And thank you for the support. You can also support us by going down and liking this video. Last video, we did just over 600 likes, which was exactly my goal. I asked for 600, and that's over 10% of the people who watched that video. So that's really good. In this video, let's see if we can do 650 likes. So go down there and smash that like button. That's gonna help the channel out a lot. So with the announcements out of the way, we can talk about some of the disclaimers that I always mention in the videos. And the first one's gonna be all the information I'm talking about is from my knowledge and my research. And there's bound to be some things that I've missed. So if you have anything to add, put it down in the comments. And I also wanna say that I'm not gonna be really opinionated in this video. It's gonna be mostly facts just to relay to you. And another important thing is that I'm gonna be discussing swing set steering only for beamed vehicles. I know you can do a swing set style steering on A-arm trucks as well, but we're not gonna be discussing that here. We're gonna be discussing strictly beamed vehicles. Like I said, this is gonna be a two-part series. In this first one, we're gonna be talking about the pros and cons of swing set steering, how it works, and how much one of these setups costs to put on your vehicle. And in the second part, we're gonna be talking about how to actually set it up on your vehicle, what material to use for parts, how to minimize bump steer, and how to get desired steering ratios. So that one's gonna be much more in depth on how to set it up. This one's gonna be kind of the intro and how it works. So the first question you're probably asking is, what is swing set steering? And the best definition I could come up with is that swing set steering is an aftermarket vehicle-specific style steering that is intended for use on vehicles with a lot of travel in order to minimize bump steer. If you don't know what bump steer is, that's simply the change in tow throughout travel. So if you see a truck going through a whoop section or something and the wheels are kind of walking throughout the travel, that's bump steer. This is a problem because it's gonna lead to terrible handling and it's gonna lead to you having to chase the wheel. So once things kind of get out of the rhythm, you're just gonna be trying to correct the whole time to get the truck back straight. And that's no fun, so you wanna minimize bump steer to avoid that. So on your factory vehicles, like an F-150, Bronco, or Ranger, or any other vehicle with I-beams, the reason you see so much bump steer on stock steering on those vehicles is one, it's not a real big deal because you don't have a ton of wheel travel, so bump steer isn't an issue. And two, it's a lot easier for the manufacturer to make that style steering because it's simply two tie rods, whereas with something like single swing set steering, you have three tie rods, and dual swing set steering, you have four tie rods. So it's a lot easier for them just to make those two and be done with it. In my opinion, if you're gonna be building an off-road truck and you're throwing aftermarket beams on it and you know you're gonna be pulling more travel than stock, I would go ahead and throw swing set steering on it. That way you don't have any issues with bump steer or terrible handling. So now we'll move into some of the pros of swing set steering over a stock setup. And the first thing I wanna mention is that it's gonna be a lot stronger. So you're way less likely to bend or break tie rods, and Heim joints are a lot more rigid than a ball joint. The second thing, which I also mentioned earlier, is that you're gonna have the correct steering geometry. So you're gonna have minimal to zero bump steer. So it's gonna be a lot easier to drive the vehicle. The last pro I could come up with is that it generally quickens your steering ratio. So a stock truck would be like two turns each way to lock. With swing set steering, you could bring that down to one, which on our truck, it's about 3/4 of a turn to lock. So it quickens the steering up quite a bit. And that really comes down to the design of your swinger and the swing set steering. But we'll discuss more about steering ratios and swingers in part two. So now we'll move on to some of the cons of swing set steering. And the first thing is that it's gonna be a lot more difficult to set up than stock steering. By no means are you just bolting things together and going out and having fun. You really have to put some effort into where your swingers are located, and you're gonna be adjusting tie rods and heims quite a bit in order to minimize bump steer. On the 92 F1 build, that took Christian literally weeks to set up the steering on, and he was working on it every single day. And the reason for that is because he didn't have a whole lot of knowledge about steering going into it. And it was his first time ever doing anything like that, so he was learning along the way. And there's not a whole lot of information about swing set steering online, so it was really difficult for him to learn and took a while. My goal with this two-part series is to load you guys up with all the information necessary to build the steering on your own and hopefully save you guys a bunch of time and research. The second con is that it's gonna take a lot more maintenance and upkeep. And the reason I say that is because you have more things that you're gonna have to replace. So on stock steering, you have just a few ball joints that you're gonna have to replace every once in a while. Whereas with swing set steering, if you're running single swing set steering, you have 6 heims that you're gonna need to replace. And on dual swing set steering, you have 8. So the amount of time to swap everything out and the cost of switching those heims is gonna be a lot greater than stock. The last major con, and this might be really important for some of you guys, is that alignment shops generally will not touch this style steering because it is aftermarket and they don't really know how to mess with it. So you're probably gonna have to do the alignment on your own. Either way, you're gonna have to set up the swingers in order to eliminate bump steer, but now you might have to take the time to set the alignment yourself. If you can find an alignment shop that will touch it, great, but that's likely not the case. So now we'll move on to discussing how swing set steering works. So we'll first discuss single swing set steering, and then we'll move on to dual swing set steering. If you guys remember the 93 Ranger build, that truck got set up with single swing set steering. And the steering video on that truck is the most viewed video on this channel. It got something like 250,000 views, which is ridiculous. If you guys haven't seen that video, definitely go check it out after this one. We go into some of the details on how the steering on that truck was built. But this series is gonna be a lot more helpful for people who are looking to build it on their own and wanna learn some of the principles and the geometries of the system and how to set it up properly. Since we have two trucks here that have single swing set steering and dual swing set steering, I thought it'd be easiest to explain how it works to you guys by just showing it on the trucks themselves. So we're currently looking at my brother's truck, which has single swing set steering on it that was built by Roche Racing. And you can see the pitman arm has two tie rods coming off of it. One of them's just like a factory setup. It has a tie rod going from the pitman arm down to the passenger side spindle. But what's different is this tie rod right here, which goes to a swinger mounted off the passenger side frame rail. So a swinger is essentially just an arm that pivots back and forth and has mounts for tie rods on it. So you have the input tie rod, and then you have the bottom one, which is the output tie rod. And that's your last one that comes down to the driver's side spindle. So it's just one more tie rod than stock, and it proves to be a lot better when it comes to bump steer. Now we're looking at the 92 F1 build, which has dual swing set steering on it. And we also have a ram assist as well. And if you haven't seen that series, go check that out as well. We go through how we mounted all this and bled the system and set it all up. Now this truck steers phenomenally, but don't mind that. Just pay attention to the other steering when it comes to dual swing set. So you can see, rather than two tie rods coming off the pitman arm, we go back to only having one coming off of it. And like the single swing set steering, that tie rod goes over and mounts to a passenger side swinger that comes off the frame rail. And then also similar to the single swing set steering, you have a tie rod that goes from that swinger down to the driver's side spindle. Now the difference comes with the third tie rod that gets mounted off of that passenger side swinger. And that comes over and attaches to a driver's side swinger that is mounted to the cross member in this case, but with an equal length truck, it gets mounted off of the frame rail. So this one is really similar to the passenger one. It just doesn't include a third one, but the ratios are the same. And the ratios are really just determined by the pivot locations in reference to the main pivot of the swinger. So this upper one's your input tie rod, and then you have an output tie rod that finally goes down to your passenger side spindle. So in a nutshell, that's what single swing set steering is, and that's what dual swing set steering is, and those are some of the differences. You might be wondering, well, should I run single swing set steering or dual swing set steering? And that really depends on what beams you're running. So if you're running equal length beams, you can only run dual swing set steering. If you ran two tie rods off the pitman arm, you're gonna run into issues with bump steer. You're never really gonna get it correct. So on equal length beams, you're always running that dual swing set steering. On the other hand, if you're running unequal length beams like we're running on both the F-150s here, you have an option of whether or not you want to run single swing set steering or dual swing set steering. And each of them has their own advantages and disadvantages that we'll discuss in the next video. But you do have that option if you're running unequal length beams. So now we'll move on to cost, which is everybody's favorite subject. And this really depends on whether or not you're building the steering yourself. If you have the ability to, I would definitely do it yourself. You're gonna save a lot of money, especially when it comes to steering. On the 92F1 build, we ended up buying a steering kit, which included two swingers and two mounts. And looking back, that was a really bad idea. We dropped $1,000 on those parts, and we ended up having to cut up the mounts and remake our own because they weren't set up properly and they weren't fitting to the vehicle at all. So looking back, if we were to do it again, we would definitely build our own swingers and our own mounts. It would have saved us a lot of time and headache and a lot of money. So if you're looking at one of these kits that you're interested in buying, I personally would not do it. I would just start from scratch and build your own. The main cost when you're building swing set steering is gonna be the Himes. So if you're running single swing set steering with three tie rods, that's 6 Himes. And dual swing set steering with 4 tie rods, that's 8 Himes. So we'll price the Himes out for dual swing set steering. So you're gonna be running 8 Himes. And if you go and buy Himes from Rough Stuff, that's gonna set you back about $300, and that's running their 7/8 Himes that accept a 3/4 inch bolt. If you're interested in using some nicer Himes, I would definitely recommend FK Rod Ends and their JMX series. That's like the cream of the crop right there. Those are gonna be the most durable out of any set of Himes, but that is gonna set you back about double. It's gonna be about $600 for 8 of those Himes, the same 7/8 Hime that accepts a 3/4 inch bolt. If you're interested in getting this style Hime, I would definitely recommend getting them through CarTech. And go through Tyler, he's a really nice dude, and he'll help you out. And if you mention our code WINGSWORLD, you'll get a discount on your order, and it'll end up being cheaper than anywhere else. Tubing is another big cost, because generally with tie rods, you're running some thick wall tubing, something like 250 wall. And in the next video, we'll discuss more of the tubing sizes and what you can run. But we'll just assume for a 20-foot stick of that, it's gonna run you about $250. The last real big cost is plate, which you're gonna need for your swingers and their mounts. And we'll just assume you'll be $100 into plate. So if you're running Rough Stuff Himes, the total comes out to $650. If you're running the nicer FK Rod Ends, that's gonna run you about $950. And it's also important to mention that these prices do not include the cost of a pitman arm, the cost of hardware, or bushings for the swingers. So you're gonna have to factor that all in for your setup. Like I said, if you're having a shop do this, it's gonna end up costing a lot more money. And you're not only paying for material, you're paying for labor, which when it comes to steering, there's quite a bit of labor involved, not only in building the system, you also have to spend a lot of time for the alignment and setting it up for zero bump steer. So you're gonna be playing with tie rods quite a bit. If you're paying for a shop to do that, the cost is gonna add up pretty quickly. So that's gonna wrap it up for this video. In the next one, we're gonna go into more detail about the steering geometry and how to set up swing set steering on your own. So if you like this one, please leave a like, comment, subscribe, and we'll see you in the next one.